located on the traditional homelands of the Puyallup tribe. The Puyallup people have lived on and stewarded these lands since the beginning of time and continue to do so today. We recognize that this land acknowledgement is one small step towards true allyship, and we commit to uplifting the voices, experiences, and histories of the indigenous people of this land and beyond. Thank you.
Thank you. How's everybody doing? That is the first time a symphony orchestra has performed on this campus since before the pandemic. I can't describe how meaningful it is to reunite with you, our audience, with our students across these instrumental areas, bringing everybody together. It's really profound, and I feel so privileged to get to be here. My name is Anna Wittstruck. I'm the orchestra director here at University of Puget Sound. And we have a really, it's not a long show, but it's a really exciting, lively one. This is, of course, our sort of final spring concert. You should come to Pops on the Lawn next Wednesday at 4 p.m. You'll be able to hear this ensemble as well as the wind ensemble led by student conductors under the direction of Dr. Gerard Morris. So definitely come for that. But this is kind of our, you know, our last moment in Schneebeck. And better late than never, all coming back together. We're really excited to be here. And also to feature a couple people. So you're gonna, in a little bit, I'll be talking about a student concerto winner who's a really, really special player and really wonderful human being. We also have here on our campus from Cuba, Mr. Aldo Lopez Gavilan. Yeah. Aldo is extraordinary. The energy in this building has been insane the past few days. And we're so excited to play his own piano concerto with him on the second half. And I want to just take a moment to acknowledge, first of all, Northwest Sinfonietta and their executive director, Karen Chu, who have made this collaboration possible and brought Aldo into our Pacific Northwest orbit. Thank you, Northwest Sinfonietta. And also a shout out to Bruce and Dixie Arnaclev, who I believe are here tonight. Yes, thank you, Bruce and Dixie, for sponsoring the Artistry Roundup. Thank you for your generous donation. All of that sounds good, right? And it is good. There are things about this last concert that always make me a little bit sad, and one of them is that we get to celebrate but also say goodbye to our senior class. And this class of 2022, you know, when people have asked me, How do you conduct an orchestra during a global pandemic?
And I think it's usually designed as a rhetorical question because like there's no good answer. But my answer is always these students. These students have provided that opportunity, their generosity of spirit, their grace, their willingness to be adaptive and flexible and creative and actually utilize the time in really meaningful and important musical ways. We did weird things on Zoom. We did improv sessions. We listened to guest speakers. We did we did breakout room activities. We did small chamber music. We made good use of the time. And so much of that was from the leadership of this class, who we get to celebrate tonight, but also say goodbye to, because this is their last concert on this stage for many of them. And so with that, I would like to go ahead and welcome the class of 2022. Please come to the stage. For your dedication to this ensemble, to our musical community. These guys are going out to do amazing things. Some of them are going to graduate school in musical performance. Some of them are going to graduate school in something totally unrelated to music. Some of them are working for a few years and in preparation for graduate school or other jobs. Some of them are staying in town. Some of them are going all the way across the country to the likes of Florida and Boston. So they're really amazing human beings, and I know this is the hard part, but it's good practice for commencement, all right? I'm going to read all of their names and their degrees, and I would like you to hold your applause until everyone has been recognized, all right? This never works. Are you with me? Okay. Jordan Anderson, cello. Is getting a Bachelor in Science in Neuroscience with minors in Music and Mathematics. Jordan hails from Mount Vernon, Washington. Eli Shinever, violin, can you wave so people know who we are? Yeah. Is getting a Bachelor of Music in Musical Performance, violin, and hails from Santa Monica, California. Sam Crosby Schmidt, cello. BM in Musical Performance, not actually cello, but vocal performance, does a lot of double duty here in the School of Music, from Woodbury, Minnesota. Christina Fritchen, bassoon, Bachelor of Arts in Sociology and Anthropology, minor in Music, from Sunnyvale, California. Mackenzie Johnson, violin, Bachelor of Science in Natural Science, Bachelor in Science in Environmental Policy, with also a minor in Music, from Minnesota. That's a lot of things. And you still came to rehearsal, I love that. Miguel Ledesma, trombone, Bachelor of Arts in Music Education from San Jose, California. Evelyn Martin, viola, Bachelor of Science in Economics, minor in Mathematics from University Place, Washington. Austin Mangle, percussion, double major, Bachelor of Arts in Business Administration, Bachelor of Music in Musical Performance, percussion from here, Tacoma, Washington. Jasmine Mikesell, flute, Bachelor of Science in Biochemistry, minor in Music from Shoreline, Washington. Sophie Paul, cello, Bachelor of Music and Musical Performance cello from Salem, Oregon. And last but not least, Bailey Ulrich, flute, Bachelor of Science in Exercise Science, minor in Music from Pleasant Hill, California. Did I miss anybody? We're good. Give it up for the class of 2022! One of them was not dressed like the others. Yeah, that's Jasmine. So you saw that her degree was in biochemistry, but she's actually one of the winners of our 2022 Concerto Aria competition. And we're going to be featuring her in just a few minutes on a piece by an American composer, Gary Shocker. So, thinking thematically, big picture, our first half of our program is all music that comes from the United States. We opened with Bernstein's Candide Overture, and now we're going to perform the Shocker. After intermission, everything will come from Cuba. I'll talk about that a little bit later. But just to caffell about Jasmine for a minute, because she's been such a dream to work with. She's so extraordinary on this piece, and it's a lot of fun. Strings, we're having a lot of fun. It's hard. It's hard. But they're troopers, and they're really getting into it. It's great. So I don't think I have anything else to say. This is what happens when I don't make notes ahead of time. So thank you very much. We're going to perform Airborne for you, and then take a break, reset, and then it will be all things Cuba. Enjoy the rest of the show.
coming back. Obviously, you're going to come back. You know, it's not every day that you get to play music with the composer, the person who wrote the music, on stage with you. So this is a very special thing, and it's certainly not every day where that composer is Aldo Lopez Gavilan. It is, I can't express how much joy this piece, this music has brought me and this orchestra. We've been challenged by it, we've been exhilarated by it, and now that Aldo is here, it has just blown the roof off the building. I can't wait for you to hear it. I can't wait to play it. Can you wait to play it? Yeah. And I think I just want to let the composer and music speak for themselves, so please help me welcome Mr. Aldo Lopez Gavilan to the stage.
Good. So I don't want to talk too much. I want to get rid of this rack, first of all. Is it possible? Yes. And talk a little bit about the concerto you're going to hear now. It's called Emporium because I was inspired by my twin daughters when they were 9, and it was their birthday. And I wanted to give them a musical present. And I improvised the main theme of this concerto for them as a birthday present. So obviously, as you can imagine, it's a very special piece. And I wanted to bring all kind of little things, magical stuff and toys and imaginative things for them. So that's why I call it Emporium. I don't know why I didn't get any other name. But mainly the theme will be throughout the 3 movements. So pay attention to that. I don't have anything else to say, but just, let's play and enjoy. All right. Actually, I want to say one more thing. I'm really very honored and I'm so happy that I'm playing this concerto with these magnificent, wonderful young musicians and with this wonderful Anna conductor. And I wish we can do a tour, world tour with this. So that's it, that's all.
Thank you.
Yes, I always need to be reminded to get the microphone. Thank you very much. That was awesome. That was really awesome. So I want to play this song that is based on a very unknown theme. You would never recognize it. And because this concerto was dedicated to my daughters, it's kind of a childish music. Yeah, right. So let's see if you can recognize this theme. Thank you.
you. You're actually not done with the Lopez Gavilans just yet. We have one more piece on the program. I was actually introduced to this family through Aldo's wife, Diana Garcia, a wonderful conductor down in Havana. I met her when I was there performing, and we got to work together, and it was one of the highlights of my musical career, and it's been really wonderful working with Aldo here and bringing this music to campus. What you're about to hear is a piece that Diana introduced me to. It's huamaco. It's a traditional Cuban dance that comes from the rumba clave from West Africa, and it has become sort of a cultural embodiment of Cuba in a lot of different ways. And this piece was written by Aldo's father, so a wonderful composer and conductor down in Havana. I hope you enjoy it, huamaco. Thank you so much for coming to our concert, for supporting our students. We hope to see you next time.